Praise the Lord. We bring you greetings from the Bible Way House of Prayer Church, located at 3261 Park Avenue, right here in the city of Memphis, Tennessee. We want you to be with us in our services. We do have prayer on Tuesday night at 6 o'clock on the conference line. That number is 605-313-4822. You can join us there. The access code is 531061, and we can take your prayer request, agree with you in prayer for whatever you're believing God for. That same number, you can also join us on Wednesday for our noonday Bible study. And we hope that you will take the opportunity to be with us in Bible study, where we just sit and walk through the Word of God. You can bring your question, also your comments, to this Bible study. And also, we meet here in person every Sunday morning. We expect a great move of the Lord. So join us here in person. We do have the CDC protocols in place, the mask and the social distancing. But we welcome you to be with us at our worship service, and there is always a relevant word from the Lord. So we, God bless you and keep you, is our prayer. Genesis chapter 15, beginning with verse 1. After these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abram in a vision, saying, "Fear not, Abram, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward." And Abram said, "Lord God, what wilt thou give me, seeing I go childless, and the steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus?" And Abram said, "Behold, to me thou hast given no seed, and lo, one born in mine house is mine heir." And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, "This shall not be thine heir, but he that shall come forth out of thine own bowels shall be thine heir." Verse 5, "And he brought him forth abroad and said, Look now toward heaven and tell the stars if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, So shall thy seed be. And he believed in the Lord, and he counted it to him," everybody say, "for righteousness." Father, in Jesus' name, we're so grateful today. We thank you for what our ears have already heard, oh God. We thank you right now, Father. We pray that you would have your way in this service. God, that you would be glorified right now, Father. And I yield my body, my mind, my spirit to thee, oh God, and say, use me as your instrument today. In the name of Jesus, Lord, let each one of us leave today with a greater expectation and a desire to please you. In the name of Jesus, God, that we will walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you call us. Father, we pray for those who may not be feeling as well as they desire, that you would touch them even while we are ministering the word. Let the Spirit touch them right at the point of their need. We pray for the bereaved family, Father, that you would strengthen and comfort in the name of Jesus. Bless those that are not here today, Father, wherever they are. God, we speak a word over them right now in the name of Jesus. We'll give you praise, honor, and glory. It's in Jesus' great name we pray. And every heart say amen. Amen. And thank God. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. In Hebrews chapter 11, I believe it is, and around verse 6, the Bible says, "But without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him." I said we're talking about a faith that pleases God. Faith is the only attribute that will get God's attention, because we have to come to him by faith. The Bible said, I believe it's in the book of Romans, by faith we are saved. So it is the key component in salvation. As I was reading and studying, and I landed on Abraham, because Abraham is noted throughout Scripture as the father of the faithful. The father of those that possess faith or walk in faith. When the Lord called Abraham, or as it says here in the text, Abram. The name Abram means exalted father. When the Lord called him in chapter 12 of Genesis, he told him, saying, I want you to get out from your father's house, from your kindred, and I want you to go to a land that I'm going to show you. There are some things, Abraham, that I want to do with you and through you. And Abraham, thank God, the Bible said he moves out by faith. Thank God. He doesn't begin, amen, to ask God a bunch of rigorous questions. Amen. Why you call me? Why you want me to go? He doesn't do like some of us. But because Abraham has a trust in God. Abraham, it's amazing to me, because he comes from a family that served pagan God. Amen. But there was something about him. God saw something in him that God would choose him. Hallelujah. You remember several Sundays ago, amen, I preached the message, and thank God, and I was talking about how that, amen, God knows what is within each one of us. He knows, thank God, that if certain things happen to some of us, he knows that in the midst of that we won't quit. I talked about Paul, thank God, Saul, and how that even when God called him, God knew that there was going to be some suffering. When he spoke to Ananias in Acts chapter 9 and told him to go lay hands on Saul that he might receive his sight. And of course, Ananias said, well, God, you know, we done heard about this man. We done heard of how he has persecuted your people. But God said, Ananias, now he prays. He prayed. So Ananias goes on, and when he entered the house, the Bible says he said, Brother Saul. And he laid his hand on him. Amen. And so my point is that God knows, amen, he knows what is in each one of us. He knows what has those gifts and those talents that have been placed in us. But sometimes there are some situations that have to transpire to bring out certain things. You can't get the oil from the olive unless it is pressed. So sometimes God allows some pressing situations to come in the lives of believers. And what I like about God, all the time, he doesn't give us an explanation as to why. He doesn't send out a warning notice that, amen, on the 16th or 17th of July, this is going to happen to you. He doesn't do it like that. We must trust him and have faith in him and know that whatever the process is, that God is in control. Praise God. Man, faith that pleases God. And so God tells Abraham, and he makes him a promise that you're going to be the father of many nations. And so as we get on into chapter 15, God has to remind Abraham, because Lot has come with him, and there has been a battle that is fought. Lot has gotten captured, and Abraham goes in to rescue Lot, and thank God, and bring him back. And on his way back from the battle, in chapter 14, the Bible says that Melchizedek, the king of Salem, thank God, amen, meets Abraham. Abraham paid tithes unto him. The Bible said that he had no beginning or no ending, no mother or no father. Thank God. Praise God. And so, praise God, when we get over to chapter 15, where we are today, God reminds Abram that, listen, my word is good, but what I need you to do is I need you to have faith in what I said. Somebody ought to praise him right there. Thank God. He said that after these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abram in a vision. The number one, he tells him, fear not. And don't be afraid. See, this is what happens sometimes in the body of Christ, because, we live in such a time and such an age. We feel like that if we give certain things a certain amount of time, it ought to have taken place. And then we begin to get antsy and anxious because it hasn't happened. But God tells Abram, listen, amen, fear not, and don't get afraid. See, we can trust the word of God. Amen. Sometimes I may make you a promise, but some situations can happen that sometimes I can't come through. But if we look at somebody and say, you can always depend on God. You can always depend on God. Amen. God will always come through. So he tells him, number one is, fear not. Because fear has a tendency that after time has transpired, amen, whatever it is that you are praying for, when time passes by, the devil will begin to speak to your mind and say, well, God hadn't done it yet. Are you sure this is what the Lord said? Amen. Are you sure you heard God when he spoke to you? Maybe, amen, maybe you just ate too many pork and beans last night, amen, and you had something, amen, happening that way, but amen, and you blamed it on God. Hallelujah. So he began to talk to us and in that manner. And so sometimes when we look at the time that has elapsed and when we're still right where we are, sometimes if we're not careful, fear will begin to try to creep in. But you got to know, thank God, amen, you got to know where you have placed your faith. Amen, you have placed your faith in God. And God cannot fail. Thank God. And so he tells them, amen, to fear not. Abram, I am thy shield. Thank God. God assures him that, thank God, a shield is used for protection. It is used by the soldiers when they go out into battle to ward off, amen, spears and fiery darts. So God says to Abram, amen, don't fear, because I am your shield. In other words, I've got you covered. Amen. I've got you surrounded. Praise God. Amen. Thank God. And the devil can't get to you unless he come by God first. So he reminds Abram that I am thy shield. Watch this. Thy exceeding great reward. Thank God. Abraham, you don't have to be afraid. All I need you to do is exercise your faith in me. Somebody ought to give God a praise. And then the Bible goes on to say that Abram said to God, praise God, wilt thou give me? What will you give me?
Amen. I remember, thank God, in my early years of being, amen, in this Christian wing, I used to hear people say sometimes, and listen, you ain't supposed to ask God no question. Thank God, you're not supposed to ask God why. Hallelujah. But listen, if God is so weak, if God is so powerless that he can't, amen, amen, he can't, pray God, deal with my why and my question, amen, then he must be a mighty weak God. But the God that I serve is all powerful and all wise. Amen. If you ask Job, Job asked him plenty of questions because of the things that he had gone through in his life. So don't let nobody tell you that you can't ask God why. Yes, you can. And God will tell you why. Amen. If you just stay before his face, because the Bible said that he is our heavenly Father and he knows what things we have need of. So thank God. Abraham said, Abram rather, he said, what will you give me? I think that the old folk used to say that serving the Lord, amen, sure gonna pay off after a while. Hallelujah, praise God, amen. And some of them that were saying it, amen, they were living in houses, amen, with holes in the floor, Brother Ford, amen. Thank God we stayed in one like that, amen. I could see the chicken run under the house, amen. But God, amen, God is good. Hallelujah, thank God I had a mother that believed in prayer. I had a mother that would go down on her knees and talk to the Lord. I had a mother that would open up this book, amen, every morning, amen. She would be in the Word, and I just believe, praise God, amen, that she was praying for me, amen, that God one day would save me, that God one day would deliver me from myself and bring me into the kingdom of God, that I would be one that would exhibit, amen, some faith in him. Give God a praise and shout hallelujah. It's all right to get a good education, amen, but a good education without God, amen, will still leave you dissatisfied. It'll still leave you in a state of confusion. Somebody say yes and give God a praise. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hey! So Abram says, amen, what will thou give me? Amen, seeing I go childless. Amen. Hallelujah, praise God, I ain't got no seed. And God, you talking about, amen, that I'm going to be the father of nations. I don't even have a child. Good God, I'm glorying. But God knows how. He knows how to bring his word to pass. But what he needs is some people, amen, that when God give the word, that we will hold fast to the word, amen, that we won't let nothing, situation and circumstances turn us around and cause us to give up on the word God has spoken. Somebody say yeah. Amen. So again, so he said, what would you give me, seeing I go childless? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And this servant in my house, amen, and the steward of my house, this Eliezer of Damascus, amen. Sometimes, amen, we want to pray God, amen, put in, amen, we want to put in our own way and do our own thing. But listen, whatever God has said, God got the power to bring it to pass. Somebody say yeah. Amen. He had the ability, amen, because his word will not return unto him void. Amen. Whatever he has spoken, God will bring to pass. Whatever he said concerning your life, God knows how to bring it through. Somebody say yes. And give God a praise. Faith that pleases God. Mm-hmm. And so as we move on, amen, hallelujah, thank God, if you get on over to chapter 17, I believe, amen, the angel comes, amen, and they begin to visit him, and God begins, he's steady assuring Abram about this promise that have been made. When you read on down, God changes the name. You are no longer going to be called Abram, exalted father. but now I'm going to call you Abraham, the father of many nations. Amen. I'm going to change your name. And some of you sitting here, amen, God has changed your name. Oh, you still got the name your mama gave you. But when you come over into the kingdom of God, God give you a new name. Now you are blessed. Amen. Amen. Now, praise God, you've been raised up. Somebody say yes. Yeah. Amen. When we can exhibit that faith in God, amen, then God gets busy, amen, doing for his children. Somebody say amen. Yeah. Over in the book of Matthew, amen, Matthew chapter 14. Praise the Lord. We're talking about, amen, a faith that pleases God. Amen. A faith, praise God, that will work. Amen. Anytime and anywhere. In any situation. Amen. Jesus has told his disciples, amen, to go over to the other side. Jesus had ministered unto the people. Amen. As it was his custom, when once he ministered, amen, the Bible said, amen, he would send the multitude away. And then Jesus, many times, amen, he would get away into a quiet place so that he could pray. Hallelujah, so that, amen, the Father could speak to him and pour back into him. Praise God, amen. It ought to be a lesson for us, amen, that when we have given out, amen, when, praise God, amen, when we have expended ourselves, that we look for a place that we can get away and seek and call upon the name of the Lord. Somebody ought to say yes. In Matthew chapter 14, and the Bible said, and when he had sent the multitude away, he went into the mountain apart to pray. See, I told you that. Amen. Jesus went away to pray. Amen. Thank God. And when the evening was now come, he was alone. He was there alone. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with the waves. Amen. He had given the direction unto the disciples to go on over to the other side. And see, some of us, as we walk with God, amen, we want step by step by step instruction. Amen. We want step by step by step. Amen. We get to the corner. Praise the Lord. So he said, go over to the other side. So they begin to go. They acted on the word that Jesus said. Now watch this. So now they're in the sea. Notice what Jesus is doing. Jesus is alone praying. Amen. See, when you're in prayer, you don't need no destruction, no distractions. Amen. Because I need to hear from heaven.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. How many of y'all take your phone in your prayer closet with you? Somebody can't pray because, amen, as soon as that doesn't bling, I got an email. Hallelujah. Well, you may as well just stop because you ain't getting nowhere. Amen. So he tells them, they're in the midst of the sea. The Bible said the waves and the wind were contrary. In the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled and saying, it is a spirit. And they cried out for fear. But straightway Jesus spake unto them, saying, be of good cheer, it is I, be not afraid. That's what he told Abraham. He said, don't be afraid. It's amazing how fear has a tendency to grip us.
Amen.
I was talking to a preacher yesterday, and he was telling me about a family member. Said, haven't been out the house in 2 years. I said, well, I said, you mean I didn't take the mailbox?
He said, from what she said, unless you can reach out the door, you know, the one that's right by the door, you know.
Two kids. Because I'm afraid that I'm going to get something. I said, well, how did you get it? She said, her husband goes out and does everything. Okay, well, he coming in contact with, and he coming back to the house. And y'all sleeping in the same. Okay, let me get back. Let me get back to the message. But Jesus said, don't be afraid. And people today, amen, the spirit of fear have gripped them.
Yeah. You're right.
I hear pastors now saying, it's time for us to come back to church. And thanks. I love Sister Turner when they say that because I stick my chest out. And I said, we've been back. Praise the Lord. I said, let me tell you this. I didn't miss but one Sunday. I missed the fifth Sunday in March when the pandemic started. Now, a lot of y'all was at the house, but I was preaching from here. Amen. That's why every Sunday morning, I got up, put my clothes on, and I came here. Me and Minister Tyler. Then it was Deacon Mark. Then it was Elder Taylor. Then it was Brother Barnes. Then Elder Tony. We were here in church. And the Lord spoke to me and said, look, people going everywhere else. They in Dollar Tree. They in Walmart. They in Target. They in JCPenney.
What you say.
They not scared to go there. But the devil